And the Lagos State Governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, says the Justice Doris Okuobi-led judicial panel of inquiry and restitution set up last Monday to investigate human rights violations by SARS operatives has had its terms of reference expanded to also investigate the circumstances that led to the shooting of protesters at the Lekki Toll Plaza. Governor Sanwo-Olu said the panel will start its sitting next Monday at the Lagos Court of Arbitration Center in Lekki. He urged members of the public to send their petitions and evidence on the Lekki incident to the panel for investigation. The governor spoke on Friday while moving around the state on an inspection of the assets destroyed by the arsonist, taking stock of losses to the government and private businesses. We're now joined by human rights activist Kabir Akinbolu. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
All right, I'm going to start here. And the governor of Lagos State, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, has expanded the scope of the panel of inquiry. What are your expectations from all of this?
Yes, my expectation would be that, you know, there have been panel of inquiries upon panel of inquiry in this land, and it should not just stop there at setting up the panel or inaugurating them. It should go beyond that. By the time they have made their recommendation, you know, under the law, constitutionally, when the panel of inquiry has been set under the panel of inquiry, they will make their recommendation to government. That recommendation will only be acceptable by the government passing a white paper. Once the white paper, when they have reduced the white paper and the white paper has been accepted, that is when the recommendation has become recognized by government. Now, after recognizing this white paper or the findings of the panel, what happens thereafter? Are they going to enforce it? If they do not enforce it, then it means that it's just a complete waste of time. And that is why you see that people are not placated or they have not felt satisfied enough that, oh, you have set up the panel. They believe that it might just be like the normal thing that has been happening. So if you set up the panel, let the recommendation be effective. Let the recommendation be acted upon. That is when there can ever be any meaningful reason for the setting up of the panel.
Okay, now you're talking about the recommendations being acted upon. The governor, of course, in his statements, you know, already said the military does not report to him, but to the president. So how do you think actions can be taken on these findings in any way?
Yes, that is where the problem might even occur, because even if you look at the heading or the title, or the name of the commission itself is, Tribunal of Inquiry on Special Anti-Robbery Squad Brutality and so on and so forth. It has not included the military. And again, there is a dichotomy between between the state, the extent to which the state can make law or can have effect to make such recommendation, and the federal government. The military is not under Lagos State government. So I am a bit, worried that the state government is saying that they should go beyond that. For instance, if they have extended the scope, can the Commission of Inquiry set up by Lagos State, can they probe into the affairs of the military and make a recommendation to the necessary body? These are the issues. And don't forget, the federal government has said they are going to set up a panel of inquiry. So there is going to be a kind of overlapping functions. In the sense, and again, it's going to cause problems or confusion at the end of the day, because, for instance, if the state has made findings, the panel of inquiry of Lagos State has made findings and said, this, we have ransacked the entire thing, the evidence before us, nobody has shot anybody, nobody has died. And if the federal government panel has sat and said, oh, army did not even come at all, or that army has come, they have killed XYZ number of people. You know, there is now a kind of a contradiction. Which of the panel's recommendation are we going to follow? It will throw distrust to the entire process.
All right, and some other thing that I've also heard in whispers is talking, first of all, on the president in his speech 2 nights ago, not mentioning or acknowledging the incidents that happened on Tuesday the 20th and the presence of the military at the Lekki toll gate. Is there already a conflict of interest there? You know, is that going to make it difficult for the state's panel of inquiry to push forward with, you know, with their findings when the president himself did not acknowledge that?
This is the problem itself. You will see there is no question amongst the various organs of government, from the state to the federal. For instance, you see that the vice president said, oh, my heart goes to the victims of the shootings. The Lagos state government said, oh, there was no killing. The federal government did not even mention it. The president did not even mention it at all. So, two positions from the federal government, the position of the vice president and that of the president. And again, the failure of the president to mention the occurrence is a very sad and unfortunate one. And I think I'm very disappointed, and I think many Nigerians were also disappointed, because an occurrence of that magnitude has occurred. Even though you have set up a panel, or you are going to set up a panel, everybody, any reasonable Nigerian, would have expected the president to be humane, to be honest enough to say, oh, I acknowledge the occurrence of XYZ. We're not saying you should pass judgment, but we are going to look at it. That would have been an issue. But you recognize the victim of the police, and the police who are victims are some other security agents who are, but you did not mention anybody at all. Something like that didn't happen at all. It is not good at all from the president. He has disappointed many Nigerians. At least for the sake of it, nobody can pretend to say nothing happened. So when this is done, it is a simulated piece of the graveyard, because the president is trying to pretend as if everything is all right. Meanwhile, it's all right. It's another problem on its own, because everything is not all right at all. The government should not. How can the military open fire on armless protesters? If that is the truth, it's not fair.
Okay. I also want to bring something else in. I'm not sure if you can, you know, throw your thoughts in as quickly as possible. The first one will be okay. Earlier today and sometime yesterday, LOMA has already started a cleanup of the toll gate and, of course, all other areas that were affected by the violence and the looting. That very likely is going to disrupt and take away a lot of the forensic evidence that might be needed in the panel of inquiry to understand what exactly happened at the Lekki toll gate. It has already, you know, it's already signs that all the evidence will be wiped away. How important do you think that is in the spectrum of things? And second, what would you want the victims and Nigerians to demand?
It is very important, because you see, cleaning up the place so much in a hurry is antithetical of the statement of the governor that he is going to do everything within his means to ensure that justice is done, not only to the state, but to the victims of the shootings. So if you clean up, it is raising a kind of doubt in the minds of the people that, oh, are you trying to hide anything? Why so much in a hurry? More so, there is still curfew in place after that yesterday. So the whole place, they should allow people to take notes, to compare notes, to do investigation, to conduct some searches on what has happened around the place, so as to bring before the panel of inquiry the evidence that are available, because the panel can only act on what is brought before them. So where there is no evidence, I think from day one, they have finished, they have passed the judgment indirectly.
What would you say to victims who demand more from the panel? Quickly, please. What more can the victims ask?
No, I think every victim has a right to demand from the panel whatever they feel is good enough to assuage their feelings or suffering. It is now for the panel to make the recommendation. But the panel should also be fair to ensure that whatever recommendation they are making will go a long way to assuage the feelings of the people and to heal the wound quickly.
Kabir Akinbolu, thank you so much for speaking with us and sharing your thoughts.
It's a pleasure. Thank you very much.